Get your Bible, say, I thank God for the uncompromised, the unchanging, indestructible seed of the Word of God. Today, I will be taught the Word. My mind's alert. My heart is receptive. No weapon formed against this Word can stand today. And we stand together in the Word of God, believing this whole book from Genesis to Revelation. That Word is truly working mightily in our lives today. I am what the Word says I am. I can do what the Word says I can do. I can have what the Word says I can have. Thank God for my Bible. For my Bible is God's Word speaking to me. And look to your neighbor. Say, neighbor, the Bible is God's Word speaking to you. So smile real big. Be a doer of the Word, not just to hear the Word. Now, before you sit down, greet two or three of your neighbors. Tell them you love them in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Glory. Ephesians 5:18. Turn with me, please. I want to talk about that this morning again on the Holy Spirit. Ephesians 5:18 says, be not drunk with wine, where there's excess, but be filled with the Holy Spirit of God. And let me read it to you again. As I was reading this and reading it and reading it and meditating on it, and do not be drunk with wine, in which there is excess, but be filled with the Spirit. And as I was meditating on this at 5:13 yesterday afternoon, well, Pastor, how do you know it was 5:13? Because the Bible says watch and pray. It was 5:13. Well, I just really believe the Holy Spirit spoke to me on this, a scripture to, we could bring it also another way to understand what he's talking about here. Not just talking about drinking alcohol. I believe he's also talking about don't be drunk with the system. Don't be drunk with the system. Don't be drunk with the world. Don't be drunk with the influences of the world, but be filled with the Holy Spirit of God. And the only way that we can be separated or not influenced from the world system is to be filled with the Holy Spirit of God. Now, I know we've been talking about the Holy Spirit for several weeks, but I'm just continue to talk about this because this is one of the things that we need to get a revelation of and how powerful the Holy Spirit is on the inside of us. And 2 Corinthians 5:17 says, we become a new creation. Old things have passed away, and behold, all things have become brand new. And when we become children of God, when we get born again by the Holy Spirit of God, His Spirit moves into our human spirit. And, you know, some people say, well, I don't want my mind to mess me up. It won't mess you up if you'll be full of the Spirit. And being full of the Spirit is a constant feeling every day of our life, staying full of the Holy Spirit. Because, as I said before, we have a tendency to leak. Amen. What causes us to leak? Fear can cause you to leak. Jealousy can cause you to leak. Gossip can cause you to leak. All kinds of things can cause us to leak. That's why we need to stay full of the Holy Spirit. So that's a good sign to find out if we're leaking or not. What have I been saying about my brother? How about my spouse? What have I been saying about my employer? What have I been saying about my church? Are you listening to me this morning? See, the Holy Spirit is a game changer. Say, the Holy Spirit is a game changer. And he's going to change some things for you. You being in a bad game for a long time, some of you, and you've been wanting the Holy Spirit to do something, But the Holy Spirit is not going to do any more than you know He'll do. And so we have to know what He'll do for us. And when we get born again, Holy Spirit moves in. But then Paul says, be not conformed to this world, Romans 12:2. Be not conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. So I got to get my mind renewed. In other words, you got to change the way you've been thinking, that you're a child of God now. And see, so many Christians can't figure out, what in the world am I still thinking about these things for? Why am I still thinking about ugly things? And why did I still think about language that's ungodly? Why do I think about sin so much and so forth? Because, see, our minds hadn't got renewed. But let me say this. Listen to me carefully this morning. Let me say this. Even though you have been born again and feel the Holy Spirit and got your mind renewed to the Word of God, we still live in this natural body. And you'll always have to deal with things that have come against your mind. You'll never get free from it. You say, well, I want God to free me up. Well, then ask God to take you home. He'll always be free then. And someone said, well, Pastor, I pray and I fast and I read my Bible. I'm faithful to my church and I'm a faithful husband. I'm a faithful wife. I'm a good parent to my children. But yet I still have these issues that fights me against my mind. The Bible says Satan comes to kill, to steal, and to destroy. Notice the first part of that in John 10:10. Satan comes. Satan comes. But see, God's a game changer. God's a game changer. He's changing some things in your life right now. If you listen to the Holy Spirit of God. You say, I believe the Holy Spirit's left me. He says, He will not leave you. He says, I'll never leave you nor forsake you. I mean, if you fell in the ditch this past week, He fell in there with you. I said, if you fell in the ditch this past week, what do you mean a ditch? I didn't fall in no ditch. Not just a natural ditch. The things you've been challenged with, things you're going through, that's a ditch. And you say, well, God's left me. No, He hadn't left you. He's always there for you, but you're not listening to Him. So when you get yourself in a ditch, He'll speak to you if you listen to Him. He'll change your situation. Somebody shout, He's a game changer. He'll change your system. He'll change the way things are going on your job. He'll change the way things will be going in your marriage for the better. He'll change your finances. He'll change things around you. He'll change. Oh my God, somebody help me preach this morning. I feel some changes taking place right now. But see, here's the thing. We got to start changing ourselves if we want other things to change. It just don't change by itself. I never seen a car yet start itself. Even though you got keys down with buttons on them, you can start them without getting in it. I didn't say that. You got to have a key of some kind to start that car. The Holy Ghost is our key to crank our engine and to make some changes happen if we get our minds renewed to the Holy Spirit of God. Fill your life with the Holy Spirit. Read the Word. Look at your neighbor and say, read the Bible. Read the Word of God. Hallelujah. Read the Word. I've been talking about the largest building in the world in Dubai and talking about, you know, when they build these big buildings and tall buildings now, they have to design those buildings where they won't tumble over because the higher you go, the more the wind blows. The higher you go, the more the wind blows. And so they've designed, these are really intelligent people, that can design a building a half a mile tall that when the wind blows, they put a pinling in that building that weighs 400,000 pounds. A pinling is a swing that goes back and forth. So when that building swings this way, that pinling will bring it right back in line. If it swings this way, it'll bring it right back in line. Whichever way it goes, it'll bring it right back in line. And the higher you go, the more it swings. But isn't God so wonderful? Amen. The higher you go in the spirit, the more the wind blows. The more the wind blows. The higher you get, the more the wind blows. The altitude. God has designed an altitude for you to have the peace and the understanding of what he's doing in your life. And in this building in Dubai, they have a room in there, what they call the tuning room. In other words, when you go up the elevator, you got to have something to stop your ears from stopping up. So there's a tuning room in there. They go in and tune it. And the higher you get, the tuning room changes the elevator's atmosphere, so you will not be affected as you get higher in him, higher in that building. Are you listening to me? See, the thing of it, there's a tuning room on the inside of us called the Holy Spirit. I said there's a tuning room on the inside of us called the Holy Spirit. And he'll keep your ears unstopped to his word if you listen to him. He'll stop the things of the world coming against you. He'll close it out if you listen to him. Amen. By faith. Now faith is the substance, Hebrews 11:1. Now faith is the substance, hope for, the evidence of things not seen. And so we have the Holy Spirit. It's like the tuning room in that building. Those men designed, smart, intelligent men designed that building so it would not break when the wind blows. God the Father said, I'll not leave you comfortless. I'll send back another comforter, which is the Holy Spirit. He'll guide you. He'll strengthen you. He'll keep you from falling too far to the right or too far to the left. But the Holy Spirit is in there, but you have to listen to him. I said you have to listen to him. Amen. John's Gospel chapter 14. John's Gospel chapter 14. And we'll look at verse 16. And I will pray the Father. He'll give you another comforter or helper, that he may abide with you once in a while. How long will he abide with you? Think about this. I'm going to give you a helper, which is called the Holy Spirit. When I leave, I'm not going to leave you comfortless. In other words, he said, I'm not going to leave you without help. I'm going to leave you with some help. That's not going to be on the outside, as I am, but will be always with you on the inside. Glory to God. Amen. God the Father designed the Holy Spirit through Jesus Christ that when Jesus departed in Acts chapter 1, when he departed, he said, you shall receive power, Acts 1:8, you shall receive power. When he departed, he left back the power, but the 120 in Acts chapter 2, verses 1 through 4, the 120 had to wait, go to an upper room. They had to wait for that power. Went in there, they prayed, waiting for the Holy Spirit to ascend upon them. And as they were praying and sitting, the Holy Spirit came like as a fire. Like as a fire, not a fire, but as a fire. And it burned into them. 120, filled with the Holy Ghost. And it said they began to speak with other tongues, other languages that nobody could understand except it be interpreted. But there are languages there. As they begin to speak, they say they're speaking, they haven't been taught our language. But see, the Holy Spirit gives you a language that you can understand as you speak in the tongues. It's important that you use that gift to communicate with the Father through the Spirit. What that Holy Spirit does on the inside of you through the baptism of the Holy Spirit, it gets your natural mind in connection with the supernatural mind, and the supernatural mind lives on the inside of us. And you got a natural mind. Now, when you get born again, filled with the Holy Spirit, you really don't lose your mind. You lose it to the things of the world, the things of influences of the world, but you don't just lose your mind. See, but some Christians, bless their darling hearts, it seems like they've gone brain dead. It seemed like it was easier to be around a non-Christian, and then when they got born again, it wasn't too easy to be around them. Because, see, some people, they get so cranked up in the Spirit and get so wound up in the Spirit and get so blessed by the Spirit that they take it to the extreme because they haven't been taught how to channel the Holy Spirit. You've heard me tell the story many times. When I first got born again, I knew nothing about God. I knew about God. I had heard about God. I've been to church just a few times in my life. But when I got born again and when I got filled with the Spirit, I really got exuberant. Exuberant. And I wanted everybody saved. You ever notice that when you first got born again, you wanted everybody born again too? And somewhere down the road, we leaked. We leaked a little bit. We don't have that enthusiasm like we used to have. We still want everybody born again, but we kind of just leave it up. If they want to get born again, let them get born again. Or maybe somebody else to get them born again. But that's not the way it goes. God said, we are witnesses. Acts 1:8 said, we have power to become witnesses. The 120 got filled with the Spirit, and they went out, and first thing happened, 5,000 people got saved. Thousands got saved because that fire was burning. We don't want to let that fire die down. We want to keep the fire stirred up. Come on now. We want to keep that fire burning bright because, see, the Holy Spirit is a game changer, and whatever you're facing, whatever you're going through in life, if you'll just be in tune with what the Holy Spirit is saying to you, he'll change things for you. God is so wonderful. He gave us the Holy Spirit where nobody else could touch anything of what he's done for us. Mankind can come up with brilliant ideas, things that we've never heard of before. Man has come up with ways of operations. Now they can take things out of you and replace it with other things. They can take a heart out of you and give you another heart. They can take a kidney out of you and give you another kidney. But God's design, he's designed through faith by the Holy Spirit of God in him, standing on his word, believing his word. Nothing wrong with doctors. Nothing wrong with getting a new heart. Nothing wrong with getting a new kidney. Praise God. But until you get one, you can believe God to get a one that's supernatural. And for some reason it don't get manifested, God will manifest one in the natural. We're serving a God that's supernatural. But as children of God, I want to encourage you today, as children of God, is to stay full of the Holy Spirit and don't always resort back to your natural mind. Your natural mind. You've got a natural mind, but let your natural mind, when you resort to that, give you words from the Holy Spirit through the Word of God. We get our minds renewed through Scripture, through the Word. Why do we do that, Pastor? Why is it designed that way? Because when the Holy Spirit moves into your life, you've heard me say it many times, the whole counsel of God's Word moves inside of you. And as you get your mind renewed to the Word of God, you'll find out what's on the inside of you. You'll find out what's on the inside of you. It don't take long to get into a conversation with someone to find out just where they're at. You can locate them pretty quick. You can find out exactly what's been put in them this past week. Because a lot of times they talk about this, they talk about that, and they never say anything about the Word, never say anything about the goodness of God, the mercy of God. They never say anything about that. Children of God. Children of God. Let me borrow somebody's cell phone. I know somebody got a cell phone this morning. And let me ask you this. When you come to church, turn your cell phone off unless you're going to use it as your Bible. Be sure you use it as your Bible. Not as a camouflage. Because if you lie, the Holy Spirit will know it. That's This cell phone, it has to be charged every day. It has to be charged every day. Every night, we charge our phones. We got one of those quick chargers at the house, and every night I'll tell Pastor Barbara, I said, I'll charge mine first. In the morning, I'll charge yours up. So when I looked at hers this morning to charge it up, it only had seven left on it. Wow. It wasn't 100%. 7%. Seven. It was getting kind of low. Oh, yeah. Matter of fact, it was almost dead. And if you notice, when your phone starts getting real low, it comes up and tells you, charge your phone. Anybody ever seen your phone do that? Come on, be honest. Come on. Has anybody ever seen that happen to your phone? It says, charge your phone. We need every child of God, the Holy Ghost, I wish he'd have put an indicator on us. So when we look to the mirror and the Holy Spirit is kind of a low percentage, that your forehead would lighten up. And let you know you're running low in your battery. The Holy Ghost is running low in your life. We take better care of our cell phones than we do ourselves. The greatest care you can take care of is make sure you stay full of the Holy Ghost. You will check your phone every day to see if you're 100%. Because you know that throughout the day, you're going to need 100%. I know I do. I need 100% of my phone every day. And the closer it gets to the dark, the less percentage I have. You know, we should do that with ourselves. Do that with ourselves. We need to be sure that we're 100% first thing of the morning. Before we leave the house, I'm full of the Holy Ghost. I'm at the top, 100% full of the Holy Ghost. I prayed in the Spirit this morning. I read some word this morning. Come on, church. When I walk out these doors, I'm full of the Holy Ghost. Not caffeine coffee. Make sure my phone is 100%, and they got me a cup of caffeine coffee. My God, I can make it now. That's just a temporary high. And about an hour or two later, you got to have another cup of caffeine and probably have two or three before you leave the house. There's nothing wrong with drinking a cup of coffee. Don't misunderstand me. I didn't say quit drinking coffee. Unless the Holy Spirit tells you to. Will the Holy Spirit tell me to quit drinking coffee? He might just do that if you're drinking too much. Too much is damaging to your body. Dad Hagin said there were times the Holy Spirit would tell him not to drink coffee or to drink sodas. Coke. Drink Coke.
No, don't drink Coke.
Not eating certain. He'll say, the Holy Spirit said not to eat meat for a while. Amen. You know, the Holy Spirit's a game changer. He's always wanting to change things for the better. Isn't that awesome? He wants to change things for the better if you listen to him. But you got to stay full. You can't let your battery die on you. Don't let your battery die on you. People say, man, I'm dragging today. You need to look in the mirror and see if your forehead's lightening up. Next time, tomorrow morning, look in the mirror, see if you're full of the Holy Ghost. And if you look sad, I'm not talking about you hadn't got your makeup on yet, ladies. You hadn't got your hair fixed yet, ladies. You can still have a glory of countenance on you. You can still have a smile about you. You still got joy. Come on. You still got some joy. You didn't let your figuration take away your joy. You didn't look in the mirror and say, man, I got a lot of work to do this morning before I leave the house. All the ladies said, Pastor loves me. I really do. And also the guys, same way, same principle, same thing. You don't have as much to take care of as the ladies do. I'm so glad I was born a man. And my wife says, I'm so glad I was born a woman. I'm glad I'm not a man. I said, I'm glad you're not a man either, baby. See, she trains my tractor, but the Holy Spirit keeps me full. So keep your batteries charged up. The Holy Ghost battery inside of you, keep it charged up. Amen. Look at somebody say, just stay charged up. Check your joy out. The joy of the Lord is our strength. I said, the joy of the Lord is our strength. How many people got a cell phone? I said this about 2 or 3 weeks ago. Every time you look at your cell phone, first thing of the morning, you say, man, I got to put a word on here from God. I need to put a scripture on here. I need to just, if nothing else, just say, God sure is good. Would you, you don't even realize by just saying, God is good. And just put, God is good to everybody. You know, God is good to everybody. John 3:16 said, for God so loved the world. Just look, when you look at your phone, say, I need to put something on there. Amen. And don't wake up first thing in the morning and say, I just ate 2 eggs, some bacon, some grits, hash browns, drank a cup of coffee, and a glass of orange juice. And that's all right. And right under that, just say, I give God all the praise and all the glory. Amen. Amen. Praise God. Use your phone for the gospel. Somebody, give me a pool. Give me a microphone. That is a microphone. You can reach more people. That's a communication tool that God has allowed to be invented, not for the world's use, but for the kingdom of God's use. And there is a lot of gospel on Facebook. A lot of gospel. Have you ever thought about taking a selfie with this? You need to take a selfie with the words that... Take it, open it up there. Take a selfie with the word. Take a selfie with the word. Find your scripture, say it. Smile real big. Look and say, just look right here. I see a lot of selfies on the cell phone, on Facebook. You know, change things up. See, God's a game changer if you... If you allow him to, he'll give you creative ideas, not just something that simple, but he'll give you creative ideas for your life. God has laid out a pattern for you. He says in Ephesians 2:10, he says, I've gone ahead of you, prepared for you a good life. How are you doing this morning? Why is that? Because God has prepared for you to live a good life. A good life, not a draggy life, a down life, a sad life, but a joyful life. Glory to God. Somebody ought to get happy in the house this morning. Somebody take a selfie sometime with hand, tongue hanging on. Oh. I've seen some of those phones and pictures of us. What would I like for a bird to fly by and drop something? So I'm going to thank God for his goodness. I said, thank God for his goodness. You know, you are as full of God as you want to be. You are as full of God as you want to be. Are you satisfied at where you're at? I'm not satisfied. I want more of God. I want more understanding of him. I want to devour him and to love him. See, we need to build such a relationship with the Holy Spirit that anytime he just taps on your spirit, just a little tap. Hey, what you want? Hey, what you got for me today? Amen. Somebody said, well, I'm waiting for God to talk to me. He's waiting for you to listen to him. Because he's always talking. Amen. Holy Spirit's always talking, always giving us instructions. But a lot of times we'll push it back out of the way. We said, not now, don't bother me now. I'm watching this movie. He'll come to you because he's already in you. He'll rise up inside of you. He'll change some things for you. I'm not going to ask you to raise your hands, but do you really need some things changing in your life today? You shout amen. We could trust the Holy Spirit to help us with that. You say, well, see, what we need to do is learn to do this. Say, Holy Spirit, help me to understand you. Help me to, when I read the word, to give me revelation, understanding of your word, Father. Lord, I don't really know how to serve you to the capacity that I need to serve you. And so what can I do to change some things? And just talk to the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is not a mist. He's a person. Holy Spirit's a person. He is not an it. He's not a man in the sky. You hear people say, well, the man upstairs? They use it like a slang word. God's on the throne. Jesus sitting the right hand side of the Father. And the Holy Spirit is on the inside of me. He's a person. And you know something? He loves us. He loves us. Put your hand on yourself and say, Holy Spirit loves me. Say it again. The Holy Spirit loves me. Don't ever say nobody don't love you. Nobody ever cares about you. Nobody ever talks to me. The Holy Spirit does. Listen to him. Thank God I am where I'm at today. I'm not where I want to be yet, but where I'm at today, I give it all credit to the Holy Spirit. I own nothing. The Holy Spirit owns everything. I'm just glad he put me in the management position. I manage what he gives me, and I pray, God, give me wisdom to manage what I have correctly. Amen. To manage what I have correctly. And you husbands, listen to me. How many husbands we got in the house? Come on, raise your hand. Don't be ashamed. What was I going to say before you messed me up? Your husbands need to pray. You're the head of your house. When I say head, I say spiritual leadership, not boss. You have somebody say, I'm the boss of my house. Yeah, she's going to crown you too with a frying pan. Yeah, I'm the king of my household. Watch out. You get ready to get crowned. Lord, you put me in management position in my family. You put me in management position. And Lord, help me to guide my family to the ways the Lord. Joshua said, for me and my house, we're going to serve God. Joshua said, for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. And you need to say, Holy Spirit, help me, because I want my household to serve God. My wife and I are going to serve God. My children are going to serve God. My grandchildren, my great-grandchildren is going to serve God. Lord, help me to guide them and to lead them. Lord, Holy Spirit, help me to be an example. Holy Spirit, I know the love of God lives inside of me. The love of God lives inside of me. Lord, by the Holy Spirit, help me to express that love. And Holy Spirit, help me not to ever get angry with someone. Help me not to hold a grudge. Help me not to hold a grudge. And thank you, Holy Spirit. Some of you are still holding a grudge. Just recently, you've been offended about something. You need to let that go. God's a game changer. He can't get you where you need to go unless you repent. You got to repent and get things out of the way. We've let race divide us. We've let politics divide us. We let money divide us. We let all kinds of things divide us. But Paul said, nothing will separate me from the love of God. Acts, Romans chapter 8. He says, nothing will separate me from the love of God. The enemy will use anything. You may be a husband and wife. I'm talking here. I don't know what they are. I don't know whether they're Republicans, Democrats, Independents, or pending something. Say one of you is a Democrat, one is a Republican. You can still make it work. Some people turn their back on another person just because they're of one party of another. Dear God, have mercy on us. We do the same thing. If you're not a Christian, I can't talk to you. You can talk to people who's not Christians. You can't drink with them. You can't cuss with them. You can't lay with them. Hallelujah. You can't sin with them. You just can't do it. But you can talk to them about Jesus. You can be a friend to them. You don't preach the book of Revelation to them. Dear God, some people, bless their hearts. God, use wisdom. You have God's wisdom inside of you. The greatest counsel, the greatest wisdom in the world is on the inside of us. Always say, Holy Spirit, how should I talk to this person? How should I act to this person? I love everybody. I love everybody. I have no issues with nobody. You may have issues with me, but that's your problem. It ain't my problem. I got my end covered. I'm covered by the blood. I'm covered by the blood. Covered by the blood. So I don't have any issues. No ill feelings, no holding no grudges. Well, everybody treats you nice, Pastor. Not everybody. A lot of people do. But that don't change my love for them. I don't let circumstances, I don't let issues, I don't let nothing change my love for the people. There's some things I don't like. But I still love them. Are you listening to me? Yes. Don't let things you don't like stop you from loving that person. Amen. I know my wife, there's some things she don't like about me, but she still loves me. How do you know that, Pastor? Because I asked her the other day, do you still love me? I'll ask her, this is the truth, tell the truth. I'll ask her a lot. I said, do you love me much today as you did yesterday? Don't I do it often? I do it. So she's told me. Amen. And that's probably some things she don't like about me. She probably don't like my snoring. Of course, I don't know whether it's the truth or not. I've never heard myself snore. I said, wake me up sometime, honey, see if I'm snoring. Let me check myself out. But you don't snore when you're awake. I don't think. You can ask some people in church sometimes. I said, I heard you snoring. No, I was awake. Holy Spirit will help us if we let him. He'll help you to keep your marriage together. 53 years he's kept our marriage together. But see, marriage is work. We had to work at it. And we have to allow the Holy Spirit to help us in that situation. People have jobs they've had for 40 years or so. Why do they have that job? They could have quit 10,000 times. But for most people, they could get help by the Holy Spirit to help them through that. Don't ever say, well, I can't handle this no more. You can do all things through Christ who strengthens us. You can't handle it on your own ability or your own strength. Amen? But you can handle it. The Holy Spirit says you can handle it. Amen? if you listen to the Holy Spirit, He'll help us stay in line with His Word. Learn to listen to Him. There are no limits. Say, no limits.
No limits.
There are no limits with God if you stay full of the Holy Spirit. No limits. Your faith will always produce when you stay full of the Holy Spirit. Just stay full. Look at your neighbor again and say, are you full of the Holy Spirit? What'd I say? Now, I'm not saying that when you're full of the Holy Spirit, you never get upset about something. You can be full of the Holy Spirit and still get upset. But here's where the Holy Spirit comes in at. When you say something you shouldn't have said, all of a sudden you got angry about something and something came out of your mouth, just flew out, boom, where'd that come from? Came from you, that's where it came from. But see, that's where the Holy Spirit penning comes in. It'll swing you right back in line. If you say, here's how it works. I said something I shouldn't have said, done something I shouldn't have done, acted the way I shouldn't have acted, but Holy Spirit, forgive me. And you know what? That pen bring it right back in line. You know what I like about him? You know what I like about him so good? Is it don't take him 6 weeks. It don't take him 6 months. It don't take him 60 days. It don't take him any line. Right then, boom, boom, pow. It's just like now, if you're not saved this morning, the Holy Spirit will come into you the moment you say, Father, come into my life. Boom. Right then. That's how good He is. Holy Spirit is so awesome. He's made it so easy. People say, no way it works like that. Yes, it does. By faith, confess the Lord Jesus Christ. With your mouth, believe with all your heart, thou shalt be saved. You hearing today, those watching live on stream? Listen to me today. God loves you. Holy Spirit loves you. He cares about you. He's a game changer. He'll change your situation if you put your trust in Him. Lay everything in His lap. Put it into His lap. He says in Peter, cast the whole of your care on Him. Cast it all on Him. James 4:7 says, resist the devil and he'll flee. Resist the devil and he'll flee. Amen. You got to do some resisting.
Yes, that's right.
Even though you feel the Holy Spirit of God to the brim,
amen,
you still got to resist Him.
Because
the Bible says Satan roams to and fro seeking whom he may devour. Let's stand this morning. Praise God. Give him a shout this morning. Come on, give him a shout today. He's worthy to be praised. I said He's worthy to be praised. I said He's worthy to be praised. You remember what I've been talking to you about also? The Holy Spirit's a genius. I said He's a genius. He'll never lead you astray. He'll never lead you in the wrong direction. Matter of fact, what I love about Him so much, if I'm moving in the wrong direction, and while I'm moving, if I'm not sure, said the Holy Spirit, this is not the way you want me to go, and speak to my heart. And then stop and listen. Just get quiet before God. Just get quiet before God and listen. You hear Him say, it's okay, or it's not right. You just know it. You don't hear no audible voice, but you just know it by the Spirit. There's a voice of the Spirit that you've got to get in tune with, and that comes through the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The voice of the Spirit. Sound of His voice on the inside. I love to hear the sound of His voice on the inside by the Holy Spirit as He's directing us and guiding us, leading us. He'll lead you guys into praise and worship like you've never been before. If you start praying, say, God, when I come to praise and worship practice, lead us like you've never led us before. Lord, as we're praying, as we're coming out on the platform, put into our spirit an anointing like we've never had before. Let the anointing of God overtake us, flow through us, use us to bring souls into the kingdom of God. Let the power of God work through you. And that happens when you have spent some time and said, God, I got nothing against nobody. I'm not angry with nobody. I love everybody. It makes no difference who's treated you wrong, who's talked about you, who's come against you. Don't like you because you're white, pale. Black or light. It matters not. That's why I love my church. God give me such an awesome, awesome church. He's given me such awesome people. And I tell that everywhere I go. I said, I don't care where I go to preach. It's nowhere like home. We're so blessed. Pastor Barbara and my family and my staff, we're all so blessed to have you guys. And my heart is wanting you to hear God so you flow in His best for you. God wants to prosper you and bless you and heal you and grant you your every request of prayer, every request that you have for God. God wants to bless you in every area of your life. But we got to get off the fence. Get off the fence of doubt and unbelief and fear, anger, jealousy. Get off that fence. You've been riding that fence long enough. I said you've been riding that fence long enough. It's time to get off right now. Amen. Hallelujah. Pray this prayer with me. Say, Heavenly Father, forgive me today of all my shortcomings. Today, I'm hearing the voice of the Spirit speak into my life greater than ever before. God's a game changer. I know He's changing some things in my life right now. Oh, thank God, for His joy is unspeakable and full of glory. The anointing is rising big inside of me. I can conquer all things. I can conquer all things through Christ, my Savior. Every head bowed just for a moment. Hallelujah. 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 You have knit. Oh, see, you have banana. You have not yet, some have not yet stepped into the path I've called you into, the path of peace and free of fear and tremendous joy. Places that I've called you before and told you to go and be a witness, and you get off the path sometime. You've let other things interfere, but I've led you by my Spirit and will continue to lead me by my Spirit, but you need to hear what I'm saying to you. There are people right now waiting for you. There are people right now waiting for you. You are a change. Oh, you are a game changer for their lives. There would be people that would go to hell because we failed to listen to the Holy Spirit. So God, forgive us. We thank you. We receive that forgiveness. We are free from that. No guilt. There's no condemnation for those of us in Christ. No condemnation. Because this moment forward, Father, we're going to do everything in our power to be led by your Spirit, to follow your leading. And if we miss it, Lord, we're going to ask you to forgive us. We're going to ask you to forgive us. And Lord, I'm determined today to walk in love with everybody, to walk in love, express my love for everybody like I never have before. And to communicate with you more, Father, through your word. You are a person. And I'm going to communicate more with you, Father, than I have ever before.